movie is obviously, you know, overtly political, and I guess the question is, were you seeking to make a political film and found the book and the project and thought, no, I could make this work, or was it the other way around?
It's the other way around.
Okay, yeah. So this is something that happened out in post, maybe, or...
No. Before we wrote it.
Right.
Yeah, but basically the source material was, I was just looking for a good crime story, you know. But the crime story that I found was one was about an economic crisis, you know, and it had a lot of parallels to what was going on around me, you know. And it was, you know, so that's how it happened.
Right.
Can you talk a little bit about working with Brad Pitt, both as the star of the movie and as a producer on the movie?
You know, as a producer, Brad is, he's not a producer in, like, you know, David O. Selznick, you know, he's a protector, essentially, of the film, yeah, and he, is instrumental in the beginning, getting the money. He's also instrumental in, helping you get the people that you want, you know, in the picture. Once we shoot, he pretty much becomes like actor Pitt, and you know, producer Pitt won't help you much with actor Pitt, you know, like if actor Pitt wants his turnaround, producer Pitt won't overrule him, you know. So you know, and then in post, you know, he gets involved again.
So it's in a sense, it's an advantage to have someone who's a celebrity as a producer, because he's, one, a drop for talent, and two, a drop for money.
Yeah.
Absolutely. And so, I'm sorry.
Yeah, and he's really also strong arms.
Yeah.
You know,
and he has the clout to, to muscle things through.
Yeah.
That's fascinating.
And you have a very distinct style visually, of course. And so when you know, Ash, with the assassination coming from that very long, epic kind of tale, and you're coming into a much different picture, crime picture, where you're visually, where's your head at? Like, how do you maybe make the leap? What are your reference points in thinking about a crime film?
You know, I wanted to make like a cynical movie, you know, and, you know, so you look at like Billy Wilder movies, and basically I was thinking of it like, you know, like an assembly line movie from the 40s, you know, I want to try and do it like that. So, you know, like, simple. The visuals of movies is not something, I mean, I think about it, and I, you know, it's like, it's not so important to me.
I guess, I mean, just for an example, that brilliant scene where Ben Mendelsohn is high and have all these camera tracking, and we were talking to him earlier, and he said it took the whole day, and it was, you know, doing all these different camera moves. When you're writing the scripts, and then, you know, thinking about just all these scenes, in your head, are you thinking, oh, if I do that, you know what I mean, you know, for this scene?
Yeah. I mean, some of that we kind of made up. It was really strange to shoot it, you know, because we had the camera on the dolly track, and we just shot it, and I was just cueing everything, you know, so I could cue the lights, and I could talk to him, run through the dialogue, and it was really weird, with the whole... You know, we're just kind of creating the feeling.
It's like experimental. Yeah, you're like...
Yeah. But I knew that, you know, I want to set the camera on dolly track and, you know, that kind of stuff. To kind of create the feeling,
Right.
Did you ever had a special public in mind when you made the movie?
Sorry?
Did you ever had a special audience in mind when you made it? Like
Americans.
Americans. Yeah. Just Americans, not men, women.
No. Well, me, first of all.
Yeah.
Yeah. I want to make a movie that I like.
That's nice.
You know, when people talk about the audience, I think they're just talking about themselves.
Yeah.
And they're using some sort of external idea to, you know, justify it or something. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah. No, I think the best thing always is if you make something that is for yourself, then you're the best. Yeah,
I think all filmmakers do, even the ones that are making, like, you know, popcorn movies, you know.
Yeah.
those are the movies they like.
Yeah.
You know?
Okay, thank you.
People will draw different political messages from the movie. I mean, especially that incredible last line, last few lines.
Yeah.
What do you see as the political message?
Well, just America's like a business, you know, and it's a racket all the way through, you know.
Speaking of the audience, do you think a lot of this might go over the heads of people outside of America?
Pretty fucking obvious, isn't it?
I don't know, because in a way everyone can sort of, I guess every country is sort of has similar issues, so you can pick the things out of it that you know, relate to your background as well, but I just wondered if...
Well, no, I mean, obviously, economic crisis has affected everybody, and the basic democratic model of government seems to be like the prevalent one, right? Capitalism seems to be the way, I mean, all the economies are linked and, you know, I mean, but the idea started there and it's spread, and we're essentially all, I mean, I feel like being Australian, we're somewhat of a satellite country, you know.
Why?
And that Barack Obama is really the president of the world, not the president of America.
Right. So his caricature and what his I guess aura is why you chose to do it during the 08.
No, I chose to do it during the crisis, you know, which happened in the middle of the election.
Right.
It's really the crisis, you know. But you know, the other thing is that the whole election is about this idea of
yes, we can, and together.
Togetherness, right? It's about the idea of community. That's what the election was about. You know, it was about like, we're going to heal the divide and we're one people and all that sort of shit, you know, which is in direct opposition to, you know, the American economic idea, which freedom means the freedom to compete, you know, for money.
Right.
And I think that's what Brad's character is objecting to, you know. I don't doubt that Obama was sincere, you know. You know, but it's like, it's a democracy. You have to persuade people.
Mm-hmm. You have any
to do plans? That, you need money. And to do that, you need business. And business have their own interests. And, you know, who really controls everything?
Mm-hmm. My favorite scene was the one with James Gandolfini and Brad talking. You know, that really long back and forth. I thought it was just stupendous. Do you have a favorite scene?
Which one? The restaurant?
Yeah.
I like the restaurant a lot. I mean, I don't have a... let me think, a favorite scene. I love the one of Brad and Scoot in the bar. Mm-hmm. You know, I think that's really good.
There's a retro feel to the film. Or like there's a retro style to the film with the cars and even a lot of the costumes. How did that come about, I guess is the question.
I don't know, I just like muscle cars.
That's a good answer.
You know, and you know, it's Patty, and and we're trying to create, is it really that retro?
Well, I just, you know, I guess the leather jacket and the slick back hair.
And Brad's
more
hair.
More timeless.
Right, is that retro?
No. I mean, it just feels like almost like a shout out to 70s crime films.
A what?
A shout out of some sort to 70s crime films. Peter Yates, you know, Friends of Eddie Coyle. Like,
they have slick back hair in that movie.
What's that?
They have slick back hair in that movie.
Oh, I don't know.
Maybe it's kind of a holdover from the book, you know, because the book's set in the 70s.
Of course,
maybe it comes up from there. But, you know, a lot of decisions in movies are very pragmatic, you know. You know, you pick the cars based on which cars you can double.
Exactly.
Yeah.
What was the decision behind shooting in New Orleans? Was that...
Well, you know, it's a story of economic collapse. So we want to go to where the economy's collapsed, and they also give you, you know, cash back.